John, thanks. We'll see you later. No easy fix. That's the latest word from the state after flooding shut down a part of I-85 over the weekend.
The DOT says it's only happened twice in 30 years. WYFF News Source Angela Rodriguez has more on why the cost may outweigh the gain. To put it in perspective for you, we wanted to show you the DOT traffic cam. This is I-85 and Pelham Road, and Brushy Creek runs under the interstate. So engineers tell us the flooding was right in here. There was almost 5 feet of water on the roadway, but engineers tell us reducing the probability of another flood like this could be extremely costly.
Early Sunday morning, part of I-85 was underwater. The southbound lanes were shut down for 3 hours.
The floodwaters came in and brought anything and everything with it.
When the rain finally slowed down, the DOT tells us 3 garbage trucks worth of debris had to be hauled off. Engineers say the culvert underneath the interstate would have to be widened in order to reduce the chance of flooding. And they say there's no easy way to do that.
You just about would have to build another section of the interstate to move it over to extend to increase the size of the culvert and move it back and forth because you can't stop traffic.
Engineers say the cost of such a project is so astronomical that they haven't even run the numbers. They say rerouting the 100,000 cars that travel that interstate every day would create a traffic problem that would be equally hard to swallow. That's why there are currently no plans to make any design changes, even though a widening project in the area could start by the end of the year.
It may be another 50 or 100 years before it happens, maybe next week, but usually it's the 50 to 100 year range, and then you start looking at what your costs are, what your gain is, what your benefit is, and weighing all that out.
The DOT says troopers stepped in as soon as the flooding was reported and prevented any accidents or injuries. It appears the floodwaters moved out as quickly as they moved in.
Engineers want to be clear. There's not a problem with the road. They say the interstate is fine. The problem is that we got too much rain too quickly. Angela Rodriguez, WYFF News 4, Greenville.